Hi, welcome back to my series on musical set theory. As I mentioned before, Forte designed this theory using mathematical formulas and statistical processes to help in the analysis of a piece. The objective was to create a methodology for the harmonic analysis of atonal works that were not conceived through a musical organization system, such as the 12-tone technique, that is, to analyze what is commonly called free atonality. His premise was that even when composers don't use a musical organization system, they are able to produce results that sound cohesive in terms of harmony. Therefore, there must be some form of underlying harmonic organization, whether the composer was aware of it or not when writing the piece. As any combination of notes is valid in atonal compositions, Forte couldn't consider the traditional concept of chords. How he came up with the idea of adapting mathematical set theory to musical analysis, I don't know. But the thing is that he did, and he ended up creating a methodology that indeed provides significant results. In my previous videos, I have covered all the basics of this theory. However, there are a couple of concepts that I've left for this video because they are a bit more complex. The first is known as similarity relations. Forte established a series of similarity relations, which can be grouped into two types, relations of maximum similarity and relations of minimum similarity. Both can be applied to pitch classes and interval classes, and he said that the relation of maximum similarity with respect to both should be considered more significant than the similarity of pitch class alone or of interval class alone. According to Forte, pitch class similarity is not especially significant, since many sets are so related to a large number of other sets. If interval class similarity is taken into account, however, a considerable reduction is effected. One might think that it should be the other way around, that the more matches there are between several sets, the more significant results are obtained, but it is the opposite. Too many matches can occur simply due to chance, so the fewer you find, the more significant the result you get. Given any two PC sets, four types of significant relations can be determined. RP, maximum similarity with respect to the pitch classes. The PC sets will be in this relation if they differ only in one element, for example, 027 and 037. R0, minimum similarity with respect to the interval classes. The PC sets will be in this relation if they don't present coincidences in any of the entries of their interval vectors. For example, PC sets 4.2 and 4.13. R1, maximum similarity with respect to the interval vectors with exchange of two inputs. This case occurs when the vectors of two PC sets have four identical entries and the remaining two entries are inverted, a case that occurs with some frequency, so much so that Forte established a similarity relation for it. For example, the vectors of 4.2 and 4.3. As can be seen, the inputs for I1, I4, I5, and I6 are identical, while the inputs for I2 and I3 are reversed. Finally, R2. Maximum similarity with respect to the interval vectors without exchange of inputs. In this case, four entries of the vectors are identical and the remaining two are not inverted. For example, the vectors of 5.10 and 5.z.12. In this case, the identical inputs are I1, I2, I4, and I6. The purpose of all this is to establish ways of comparing PC sets, and to be able to draw some meaningful conclusions from it. The next concept is segmentation. In Forte's own words, by segmentation is meant the procedure of determining which musical units of a composition are to be regarded as analytical objects. The idea here is that once we are faced with a piece that we want to analyze, we have to find a way to group the notes into meaningful analytical objects, which in set theory we call sets. Segmentation is a very complicated subject, and Forte recognized this. The problem is that even if the composer used specific groupings of notes during the composition process, whether he called them sets or not, the boundaries between them are blurred in the final result. Segmentation is then the process by which we try to set those limits, and there can be no other way to do it than by trial and error. In fact, we have to make several attempts and then compare them, with the idea of establishing which of them produces a more significant result. Let's take this musical fragment as an example. Where are the sets here? Are these the sets? Or these? Or perhaps these? In the first case, we get this. And this is the result of the second case. Not much improvement. However, look what we get in the third form of segmentation. We can now see that the entire fragment can be understood as consisting of just a couple of sets. Now, this doesn't necessarily mean that we have found significant elements of analysis. If this is the entire piece, then yes, these are significant elements. But if this is just part of a larger work, these sets would be significant only if they also appear in other parts of the composition, and only if they are repeated enough throughout it. The final concept, and the most difficult to understand in Forte's book, is set complex. Consider two sets, S and T, where S is a subset of T. Then S will be part of the set complex of T if and only if S can satisfy one of the following two conditions. S is included or includes T, or S is included or includes the complement of T. To understand this, we can make an analogy with tonal harmony. We say that there is a relationship between the keys of C, G, and F, and their respective relative minors. We call this a circle of fifths, and this is the first circle, the circle of C major, because that key is considered to be the center around which the other keys revolve. The set complex concept is similar to this. We say that there is a set complex for any given PC set. In other words, a group of sets that are related to it by means of relations of maximum and minimum similarity, just as occurs between the keys of the first circle of fifths. Some sets will be closer to the PC set we're considering, some a little farther, and others very far away. I'm not going to go into more detail about this, because it's very difficult to explain. My sole purpose is that you understand that the application of set theory to musical analysis is more than simply comparing the pitch classes or the interval classes of a bunch of sets. It's much more complicated than that, and involves the use of tools for statistical comparison. If you want to delve into this, you'll have to read Forte's book. But be warned, if math isn't your thing, you'll absolutely hate it. Now, so far I haven't shown you Forte's catalog. Here you have it. You'll find it on Wikipedia. I'll leave the link in the description. As for Carter's book, you can find a portion of it on Google Books. There you'll be able to find Carter's entire chord catalog, as well as a table linking it to Forte's catalog. In my next video, I'll show you how to read Carter's book, which isn't hard at all. Now, if you're wondering if you should buy any of these books, I recommend checking out your local library first. They are not cheap, and they are not necessarily books that you should have on hand, like harmony or orchestration books, which are much more essential. Finally, there are also a couple of apps that you can use so you don't have to manually check these catalogs. The first is the PC Set Calculator, which is online and totally free. It's a bit old, though, as you can see, but it gets the job done. I use it all the time. In my next video, I'll show you how to use it. The second is an iOS app called Pitch Set Calc. It doesn't have all the features of the PC Set Calculator, and it's not free, but if it suits your needs, it's a good option. And it also plays back the sets, which the PC Set Calculator doesn't do. That's all for today. I hope you now have a better understanding of how this theory is used in musical analysis. In my fourth and last video on this topic, I'll show you how I use set theory to compose and explain why I consider it an essential tool in my composition process. Until then, take care. Ciao.